Hi, I'm Avina Sajwan and welcome to my channel Engineers Mania. I am a postgraduate student from IIT Kharagpur
and a PhD scholar at IIT Delhi. We know that the model equilibration is a very important aspect in the software modeling of any problem. So to save your precious time, today we will talk about how to attain equilibrium in a model efficiently, which saves our time. So we will start with creating a project and starting a data file. And we will start with the basic commands like model new, and we will provide the title to our file, as our title for this project can be balls in a box. It's a very crude way to identify your files. After that, we will try to set the domain extent so that each and everything will be circumscribed inside our domain. We will define the dimensions of the domain. And the condition, which I will suggest here, will be stop, which means once the ball touches this domain, it will stop. Now we will try to define the slots of contact model assignment table, which will define the properties for all the contacts. Here we will define a basic model, which is linear contact model. The properties which it requires are very simple, like normal stiffness, shear stiffness. After that, we will create a box inside which we want to settle down our balls or our particles. We will give the dimension of the box and we will assign a keyword one ball. By this, we assign all the walls of a box a single name so that we can address it at a single time. Now we will give a random seed number so that the results are our deterministic and we can recreate our results. We will try to create balls inside our box. We want balls more than 300. We will assign the radius of the balls, the region in which these balls will be created. If we want balls more than 300, so I'll assign a number which is more than it. So even though if the region volume is not appropriate for generating these balls, it will try to create as much balls it can. It's a very important aspect to remember to assign the density after we have generated the balls. If we will not do this, it will create a very huge error. Here we have assigned the density of the ball, which is 1500, which is more than that of water. And after that, we will assign the gravity. We will save this as initial state because we are trying to run multiple simulations on this basic state. Now, if I just solve this without any damping or without additional assistance from any energy consuming phenomena, you will see that it's very hard to equilibrate the model. So here I have set timestep to auto. And we will solve this time frame of 25 seconds and we'll see how the model responds. So after that, we can save this file as a case A, where we know that it's no damping case. So assign a file name suitably so that you can at a later stage identify which file result is assigned to which home. You can see here we have box and walls. As you can see that the balls are colored according to their velocity, having collision with each other, and there is no energy consuming mechanism which is forcing the balls to come into equilibrium. So even though 14 or 15 seconds have already passed, but system is behaving in a random and haphazard manner, and the system is not going towards equilibration. The system will consume all of the time which we have given it to run, and it will not equilibrate easily. So this is the problem. For further study, they need a model which is already equilibrated. So model equilibration is very critical step in software modeling of any system, especially in discrete element method. So here I will show you address this issue and attain the equilibrium efficiently. One is that we can assign a energy decomposition mechanism by friction or damping. So here I will again restore the initial state of the model and I'll assign the properties. Here I will give the assigned additional properties friction and normal damping ratio, which will consume the additional energy and try to bring the system towards a more stable state. We have updated the contact model assignment table. So remember to apply this command contact cmat apply, which applies whatever the changes you have made recently to the model. Now we will just run the model once again. And this time the case can be damped system. And we will save this file as case B. Now we will run the system and we see the results in our plot table. Velocities of ball has already reduced significantly. On the left hand side, you can clearly see the magnitude of the velocities. With so much little time in, we have already seen the velocities of balls have reduced significantly, and it has already taken a very huge step towards the equilibrium. And you can see the model values are very close to our target values. Equilibration is not at a ratio of 10^-4. Many researchers assume it to be as 10^-5 or 10^-6, where ratio of unbalanced force to the total force in our system. So we can say that when unbalanced force are minuscule, then we can say that our system has equilibrated. After a long run, still it's not converging, because there will be some particles which will not be able to consume the energy. A small amount of unbalanced force is propagated throughout the system. Very few particles with unbalanced forces and small velocities which are not letting the system to come to a complete equilibration. Although it is a better model than the previous one where we did not have any damping, but still it's consuming our time, which could have been assigned to our other tasks. We will interrupt this process and we will look at a final step, define the second model, and we can see that how quickly the system converges to our equilibrium state. Now we can copy all the things from the second state, and there is a minus change which we will do in the third case. Here we will introduce a concept of time step scaling. Time step is very small, in the range of 10^-4 to 10^-5. So what we will do here is we will force the system to run with a time step of 1 second. This process is strictly done to attain equilibration only, because we are not concerned with the dynamics of the system. For the regular simulations of the DEM, we do not use time step scaling. After using the scaling time step, what we can do here is allow the system to run to a few steps, like 2000 to 3000 steps, and we will calm the system. The reason for not attaining equilibration easily is because whenever we have generated the balls, it is coming with initial velocities inherent to the system, which is as a noise. So the initial velocities, which are random velocities to the particles, they are not allowing the system to converge to equilibration. So what we will do here is, in each calming steps, like we have given the calm 200. So in each 200 steps, all the velocities of the particle will reduce to zero. And it will start again the dynamics from there. And again, after 200 steps, we will reduce the velocity to zero again. We create a certain types of dynamics where we don't allow particles to have very high velocity magnitudes. So these two are critical joint steps, using scaling time step and calming natures, to attain equilibrium efficiently and easily. You can try to attain the equilibrium in a stage-wise manner, where you reduce the ratio of unbalanced force stepwise so that the system does not get overloaded. Whenever you are towards the final steps of your equilibration, you set the time step to auto mode so that your dynamics of the system is accurate. So we will run this model once again, and you will see that how efficient it is. So now you can save this as case C. We will run this system. Particles are turning red. It means the velocities has been converted to zero once again. Now you can see how easily it going to converge. It didn't even take more than 20 seconds. The system has already converged. So this is how you attain model equilibration easily and efficiently in PFC. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this type of content, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Tune in later for the next video on how to add physics to discrete element models. Thank you.